Hey family, what's up? I want to share an experience I had yesterday. Let me fill you in very quickly. I'm in service with plant medicine, except for ayahuasca, San Pedro, peyote, and iboga. Simply because I believe these medicine should dwell with the indigenous people. A few days ago, three medicine women reached out to me. Non-indigenous, beautiful people, big-hearted. They asked for permission to use my ceremony place. And of course I agreed. On the first day they performed a cacao ceremony. On the second day, jape. And on the third day, ayahuasca. I cannot claim to know all the ways to serve the medicine. And I don't know all the tribes. So I was curious about how they approach and work with it. So at first, the group, including a few first timers, were introduced to the standard rules, no chit-chatting and interfering in other people's healing process. The ceremony in the end happened indoors, and the music was mainly based on Santo Daime religion and Indian mantras. And now and then they picked up the drum and they chanted. And here's what I observed and what I think. I'm aware of my projection and I'm trying to be careful with my judgment. I don't enjoy indoor ceremonies much because it feels like keeping an animal captive in a cage. This medicine deserves an open sky and nature so the energy can flow more freely. I guess they chose indoors because of safety reasons. The medicine women excluded themselves from the chit-chatting rule and they were giggling and laughing in a silly manner throughout the ceremony. I'm used to light ceremonies, but that was new. I imagined an inexperienced participant under the influence of a psychedelic substance, the doors wide open to the subconscious, opening boxes of trauma, trying to deal with it. And being exposed to this frequency, the drumbeat accompanied odd chanting, imitations of native sound. Only one girl could sing and the other two were irritatingly out of tune. Indian Sanskrit mantras and Indian mythology are beautiful if used in the right circumstances. throwing ancient sacred words from different cultures into an imaginary pot, stirring it up and pouring it into a retreat like this might not always serve the intended goal. Ayahuasca supposes to clear our vision. In this context, an accidentally induced identification with religious concepts by praising Jesus, Krishna, Shiva is possible. Again, I don't know all the ways and I don't know all the tribes, but I have been on many, many ceremonies here in Brazil, indigenous and non-indigenous. And I saw the good, the bad, the ugly. And yesterday it felt off. So, as a guardian of this place and the medicines, I saw myself with the responsibility to speak up. So I did after the event. And as you all know, you cannot raise someone's consciousness by calling them out. So I decided to tell a little story about what I have had privilege of learning about ayahuasca in the last 6 years. Ayahuasca is old, and no one really knows how old it is. Let's assume 1,500 years. She's moving like the sacred serpent Jiboya through time. And the indigenous people of the rainforest, they carry her spirit with their music through the centuries. And this music, the Icaros, it's not all about healing and cure. These are prayers to protect the spirit of the medicine, to call the spirits of the forest. Difficult to comprehend the importance. And 500 years ago, the Europeans showed up, took away the indigenous land, their beliefs and their way of living, brought even the African spirit to this continent by force. And the natives saw these men are sick. They lost their connection to the spirit. And at some point, these foreigners made contact with the medicine. They introduced new languages, new music, new energies, created even religion around it. Well, some people call this interference evolution. The question is, does an old tradition like this need an upgrade or transformation? So I left the medicine women with this question and the idea that we not only carry the responsibility for the medicine, but also the necessity to know the indigenous ways. And I'm aware that I'm sawing on the branch which I am sitting, because I'm a European living in South America, and from a particular point of view, I'm part of the problem. I'm working on that. The New Age period gives birth to neo-shamanism. And those people, or many of those people, have a shaman or healer complex, which is often a symptom of working with psychedelics. Many of us faced it, but not many grew out of it. Depending on the tribe, a shaman's or page's mother is already under the influence of ayahuasca during pregnancy. They carry its information within them. You cannot teach that. No matter how many ceremonies you participate in. Well, in the end, I'm not sure if they understood what I tried to transmit, because they left me with a bottle of the medicine. I am 43 years old. My lifetime compared to ayahuasca fits around 40 times into this bottle. Who am I to administer this titan? I won't serve the medicine, and I won't work with it myself. I will find a different purpose for it. Now, I'm reaching out to all my fellow medicine men and women. I love you. If you serve ayahuasca but haven't trained with a page in the Amazon rainforest for years, or haven't been initiated by one of them, consider an apprenticeship with them to build a solid structure, a solid understanding of the medicine. Wearing feathers in your hair, burning Palo Santo, and your good intentions are not enough. Talking science is not enough. It's like a good mechanic won't necessarily make you a good driver, and vice versa. Our duty is to support the indigenous medicines, not to conquer them. And I know helping someone makes you feel good. But for many, helping others is easier than to help themselves. If you work on yourself, you will heal the people around you even without serving the medicines. Again, what I'm doing here is very delicate. As a medicine man and a client, it is very difficult to pass judgment on fellow craftsmen. without pulling myself into the reference point, rather to judge someone from where the person stands. Last night's experience compels me to enter my discernment. I will think about where I placed the ego, where the soul should have been. I'm grateful for this opportunity to grow. To all my brothers and sisters reaching out for plant medicines, ayahuasca ceremonies belong to South America. They don't have to be held only in Peru, and they don't have to be expensive to be original. Try the indigenous ones first. Avoid them overseas, like in Europe or in the US. Yes, it's possible if performed via pagé. Otherwise, it's like pouring ketchup over the caviar. Psychedelics are tools, like a hammer. You can build a house, or you can smash someone's head in.
Smash!
Psychedelics are not an alternative for psychotherapy, but rather support it. Know your shit before you book the gig. Much love. Aho.